In Party Balloon Pile Up, the guys now know the best case balloon.
I think we have winner.
So, cue more car crash carnage.
We're gonna run the test the exact same way. We have our two clowns, one in the passenger seat without a seatbelt, one in the driver's seat with the seatbelt. Both of them will have accelerometers attached to them. We're gonna take the car up with the crane, drop it from 41 feet so it's traveling at 35 miles an hour, let it crash into the ground and see if the balloons make a difference.
Remember, with regular latex balloons, the clowns peaked at 620 Gs, six times over the lethal limit. But for this test, the guys aren't just opting for their optimal thick balloons.
I love to pump some helium every now and again, yeah!
They're also packing them in as tightly as possible.
This is like how we used to pack for family trips.
To try to ensure that they form an impenetrable barrier.
Trying to fill a couple gaps by blowing them up in place.
And while they may not represent realistic driving conditions, it is giving this myth the best chance of success.
Take her up.
So we're about to drop the clown with the balloons. Now remember, our benchmark is 100 Gs. We need to see the balloons decrease the G load below that. If he goes over 100 Gs, the clown is dead. And so is this myth.
All right, this is clown car dropped with our best latex balloon. Here we go in 3, 2, 1.
Yeah.
Whoa.
God.
I think it might have worked, man.
I think that clown may have survived.
What a beautiful sight. I saw that clown car descending towards the earth, and then I saw the high speed. Now, in the high speed, you actually see the car start to compact. The balloons separate just enough for a clown face to peek through and a clown nose to dust the windshield and then start to go back into the car as if the balloons are bouncing him back.
All right, Byron, how'd we do? Did either guy get under 100 Gs?
Now, you'll remember he sustained over 600 Gs with just the party balloons, but this time, only 130.
Wow, that is a huge reduction in the G load, but still 130 Gs to your body. There is no way you're gonna survive that.
Yeah, unfortunately, we're gonna have to call this one busted.
Totally busted.
Thought for a second there it had a glimmer of hope.
Nope, still dead.
Now with this last and final test, we're trying to get below 100 Gs on our clown. That is our benchmark for survivability. We've addressed all the problems that we've experienced with all the other balloons. We have small balloons on sheets of plastic. That way the clown can't push through the middle of the balloons, and if one little balloon breaks, it's not gonna create a big cavity where the clown can actually fall into the windshield.
It's a souped up solution that's do or die for the myth. If this doesn't work, nothing will.
All right, here we go. This is bubble wrap in 3, 2, 1. It did not look good.
Let's go check the data for the party balloon pileup.
All right, so how did the clowns do with the balloon bubble wrap?
Okay, so the passenger's head peaked at 220 Gs and his body at 230 Gs.
Wow, so the clowns actually experienced a bigger G load than in the previous test.
So party balloons are not a substitute for airbags or seatbelts.
Stop clowning around.
Honestly, the results of this test are a little disappointing. I mean, I really hope that we could create a survivable party balloon experiment here. But I guess when it all comes down to it, the most important thing is that you don't use party balloons as an airbag.
There you have it. Balloons and clowns don't mix.
Well, they do mix, they just don't save their lives.